नीरज सर, वी आर लाइव, प्लीज गो अहेड।
थैंक यू हरीश, थैंक यू सो मच। सो वेरी गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, आवर फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम वेरियस पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री। मायसेल्फ नीरज अरोड़ा, आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ एसोचैम जैम ग्रीन बिल्डिंग काउंसिल एंड स्पेशली एसोचैम जैम गुजरात चैप्टर। आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम यू ऑल ऑन दिस अनदर वंडरफुल वेबिनार फ्रॉम एसोचैम जैम गुजरात टीम। सो फ्रेंड्स, आवर टूडेज वेबिनार इज ऑन वॉटर, द वे ऑफ लाइफ, एंड फॉर द डिस्कशन वी हैव very special speakers, starting with Mr. Deepan Mehta. Deepan Mehta ji is the secretary for SOCHM JAM Gujarat chapter and managing director Aqua Utility Designs Management Private Limited. Welcome Deepan ji. We have with us our chairman SOCHM JAM Green Building Council, Mr. Pankaj Dharkar. Dharkar sahab is the president for Pankaj Dharkar and Associates. We have another wonderful speaker with us, architect another Tatu, Anand Tatu, chairman SOCHM JAM Gujarat chapter, chairman IIA Gujarat chapter, and chairman Anand Tatu, architects and planners. We have with us architect Lokendra Balasariya ji, co-chairman SOCHM JAM Gujarat chapter, and founder Treevox, director Second Alliance Foundation, partner La Spezio. So thank you and welcome all eminent speakers, and thank you audience for attending the program. Now I would request Mr. Pankaj Dharkar for the special address. Over to you, Dharkar sahab.
thank you Neeraj for that introduction. Can I get the screen share, sir?
Yes, please. You have, sir.
Sorry, do you see my screen, sir?
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
So first of all, thank you, Neeraj, again, and thanks to Gujarat chapter, our leaders Anand Tatuji, Lokendraji, and Deepenji. All of you, special warm wishes to you for ensuring that you are covering such an important subject today. And I am really delighted that our own leader, and who is the eminent consultant of the country, is going to tell us a lot about this. So thanks to you for taking out time, and thanks to Gujarat chapter for choosing this subject, which is of prime importance to the nation. So friends, I think I will quickly try to introduce you the JAM certification program. ASSOCHAM, as you know, is comprising of more than 4.5 lakhs member, and it is working towards creating a conducive environment of India business to compete globally, with more than 400 chambers and serving nations from 1920. And ASSOCHAM has taken a green initiative to take care of Mother Earth and to complement India's sustainability, have formed this council and JAM sustainability certification program with clear objective to promote environment friendly green building design and construction. We have several additions coming up during this pandemic. We came up with a special certification program for green healthcare facilities. We are constantly upgrading our standards, and also a very important step we took towards green warehouse and logistic campus, and many more, including on home. I am looking forward for Mr. Lokendra ji to lead us in the country on the net zero homes. I think a very good initiative taken by him. Friends, I think our certification is completely based on ECBC 2017 and National Building Code of 2016, which we believe are the two wonderful documents our architects and engineers have given to the globe. And the certification program covers sustainability, daylight energy, water efficiency, indoor air quality, fresh air, more green areas, human comfort, and more important to me is also covers fire and life safety. And this is the only program in the globe which covers this. Friends, we are also addressing United Nations SDGs 2030 goals, and it is aligned with with that, and it is the first comprehensive rating system in the world to recognize sustainability rather than incorporating few components of it. Friends, we do believe that all the certified projects first will give a payback of less than 3 to 4 years, and we all know that the buildings are built for more than 50 years. Friends, we are now present across the country. You can see here the greens where our chapter exists, and our upcoming chapters are in pink, which shows we are soon be there in states of Andhra Pradesh, also Kerala, Tamil Nadu, 7 states in the northeast region, and also Jharkhand. So we are moving fast under with the support of entire team, and it is very heartening that our certification program is now being recognized by CRESIL along with IGBC, USGBC, GRIHA, and H. So you can see here the document, and also states like Rajasthan have already started giving FAR advantages of 5% if they are certified on GEM 3, 10% if they are certified on GEM 4, and for 15% if they are certified with GEM 5. So this is a very heartening development, and I'm looking forward soon. You will see this notification, and Gujarat, with the help of Tatuji and our ASSOCHAM Gujarat team, to be there. So this is how we are certifying. It's a yardstick of 0 to 135 scale. And if you are beyond 105, we rate at GEM 5, and 40 to 49 is GEM 1 certification. Friends, we are working with several organizations in our mission, which includes NIRI, Indian Institute of Architects, NERADCO, Indian Society of Lighting Engineers, Fire and Security Association of India, ISHRAE, very important TERRE, T-E-R-R-E, which with whom we also did a very important program on net zero building, and that's where we are working very closely with them. Smart Habitat Foundation, and also our societies like Global Association of Corporate Services, who maintain the properties and facilities. With that, Solar Society, and also international societies like ASHRAE, Indian chapter, and also International Association of Indoor Air Quality Association. So it's a very important that we work together with them. We are very pleased to let you know that currently in our Mission 100 University, going to Mission 100 universities, we have signed 80 MOUs in this pandemic. You can see the names here. State-wise, you can see here, Maharashtra tops here with 23. And you can see close to 16 states have our MOUs already. Gujarat is fortunately with 4, and I'm looking forward for many more to come. And Anand ji and Lokendra ji are working on this. So I'm sure soon we will catch up with Punjab and Maharashtra, and we will have good numbers from universities across the country. We did very important this association with TERRE on net zero, and this was one important program I thought I will just share with you, where Rajendra Shindeji, who is a former director of United Nations Environment Policy Programs, was a part of this. We have certified more than 1500 professionals during this pandemic. We do conduct free of cost webinars, educational program to tell you more about GEM certification program, and Neeraj has been conducting it regularly on the last Saturday of the month. You can do this exam of online, 90 minutes exam, open book exam, and you can become professional. We also did important step by signing up with the Bureau of Energy Efficiency and create awareness on performance contracting. And this time we have already we did work with World Bank here. We got eminent speakers from Washington on these projects, and I'm very glad that this program is taking a new height, because we want to create huge business opportunity and bringing sustainability on old projects. So this is a very important movement which ASSOCHAM has started with BE, Currently, we did one program with air conditioning industry, the second program with electrical industry, the third program was on hospitality industry, and the fourth program was on healthcare industry. And it was really appreciated by all of end customers, and this gives opportunity, business opportunity also to the people. Friends, we have currently huge number of projects which are certified, which includes electrical and electronics giant like Siemens, a pharmaceutical company like Abbott, a luxury brand hotel like Hilton, ITC, and several universities, IT parks across the country. Then the list is improving day by day. And you can see here the quality of projects which have been certified by us. And which also includes some important project for our state of Gujarat. This program is being organized by our Gujarat team. So the Leela Hotel in Gandhinagar is GEM 5 certified. You can see here Mr. Rathore accepting the certification from Anand Tattoo sir. So this was a proud moment for us. This is a project which last 16th Prime Minister inaugurated. And this is an important stepping stone. With that, we also certified the Habibganj railway station. Two new redeveloped projects of railways have been GEM certified, and you can see the huge and also important land port terminal at Kartarpur Sahib corridor, which is again an important project for the nation, is GEM certified. In UP, many affordable housing projects. And friends, I would like to not steal thunder from Neeraj ji. We are going to have a fourth International Sustainability Conclave and Awards this year from 19 to 21 October. And I'm going to talk a little more. I think Mr. Neeraj will tell you more about it soon. So friends, let us all please to create a green and environmental sustainable country, and compliment Mr. Modi's vision. And once again, thanks to my Gujarat team, and also especially Dipenji, who is going to be our passionate speaker to this evening. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Dharkarji. Thank you for this very energetic presentation. Dharkar Saab, as you said, definitely we are going to organize the ASSOCHAM GEM 4th International Sustainability Conclave Expo and Awards in October. So 19th, 20th and 21st October will be the virtual program, and 23rd will be the physical program in New Delhi. So let's hope for the best that we can do the physical program in Delhi. And I would request my team, my IT team, to please run a short video on this. And then I would request Architect Anand Tattooji for his special address. So Harish, please run the video. Thank you, Harish. Thank you so much. Now, I would request our chairman from GEM Gujarat chapter, Anand Tattooji. Anand Tattooji is an architect and planner since 1984 and has successfully completed a large number of projects in the field of architecture, planning, and interior design across India, Africa, UK, USA, such as R&D centers and laboratories for major pharmaceutical companies, townships, affordable housing, educational institutions, tourism projects, including Seema Darshan at Indo-Pak border, and heritage restoration and revitalization projects. He is the chairman for IA Gujarat chapter and chairman Anand Tattoo Architects and Planners. So Tattoo Saab, over to you for your welcome address.
Thank you, Neeraj ji, for that wonderful introduction. On behalf of ASSOCHAM GEM Gujarat chapter, I welcome all the participants in this very important and relevant knowledge session. It is observed, our country is a country of extremes. On one hand, the privileged few are consuming extremely large quantities of water and mindlessly wasting this precious resource in the name of luxury and comfort. And on the other hand, majority of the people have to really struggle even to get their bucket full of water for survival. This situation has to improve. Now, conservation of natural resources such as materials, building materials, energy, and water is the basic motto of ASSOCHAM GEM's sustainability mission. And water conservation is among the top parameters in our list of principles. We have a list of 28 principles against which we evaluate the projects which are submitted for green building certification. I'll just show you this list of principles which we have, out of which the highlighted ones. Principle number 7 to 11 are dedicated to water resources and its conservation. I'm not going to read them out, but they total up to 26 points out of the 100 points which Mr. Dharkar mentioned, 105 points for the 5 GEM. 26 points are dedicated to this water alone. So friends, ASSOCHAM GEM is really serious about this problem and the requirement for improving the situation. And is that is why we have given so much of weightage to water conservation. Even the government of India has realized the importance of water conservation and has recently formed a dedicated Jal Shakti ministry. Government of India launched Jal Shakti Abhiyan in 2019, a mission mode approach to improve water availability, including groundwater conditions in water stressed districts. In addition, Catch the Rainwater campaign has been recently launched by our own Honorable Prime Minister in 2021. Friends, we are really fortunate to have Dipen Mehta, a technocrat dedicated to this cause, who will, with his vast experience, share his knowledge and experience with us today on water conservation. And he's the key speaker for this evening. And it is my privilege to introduce Dipen Mehta. A civil engineering graduate, Dipen went on to complete courses in project management, fire safety, and HVAC. He is the managing director of PCS Project Management Private Limited and MD of Aqua Utility Designs and Management Private Limited. He's also the proprietor of Aqua Designs. Apart from being one of the leading project management and utility consultants in the country, Dipen is associated with a large number of professional institutions. He is currently the chairman of Fire and Safety Association of India Gujarat chapter. He is honorary secretary of our own ASSOCHAM GEM Gujarat chapter. He is on executive committee of so many professional institutions such as Indian Plumbing Association Gujarat chapter, Gujarat Institute of Civil Engineers and Architects, ISHRAE, and many more. He is also active in academics and teaches at reputed institutions like SEPT, that is Center for Environmental Planning and Technology in Ahmedabad, LD College of Engineering, Nirma in University, etc., etc. He is an accredited trainer of Green Plumbers India, that is GPI, and also GRIHA. He has been making several technical presentations across the country and has won many awards. Friends, I can go on and on, but now we are keen to hear from Dipen. And so I proudly present our own multi-talented and a true multitasker associate, Dipen Mehta. Over to you, Dipenji.
Thank you, Anandji. Thanks for the nice introduction. Good evening, friends. Before I take it forward, let us hope for the first gold for India in Olympic by Mr. Neeraj Chopra. We are hoping for the best. So let's pray for that. Okay, I'll start my presentation. My screen is visible?
Absolutely, sir.
Right. Thank you. Now, today's presentation, the concept is to create the awareness among everyone who are present today. And I thank you everyone for being there. And we are going to learn how to conserve the water, how to change the habits and save the water. Recycling of the water, we'll just touch upon the fundamentals, and rainwater harvesting. And ultimately, I want you to act as a water ambassador, which is a need of the present situation. So do you know all about water? So we'll go through the fundamentals. I'll take you back to the school, schooling years, and then we'll take it forward to the for the common people, and then more technicality of that. So I'm going to cover do's and don'ts for bad and good habits, then our India and world situation for water, and what is the theory of 3R, which is reduce, reuse and recycle, then how you can save the water using low flow fixtures, then about rainwater collection and reuse and recycling of the water. If time permits, I'll take case study of each and every point, so you can have more idea about that, and even about costing of the system. So do you know that over 70% of the world is covered in water, whether it is fresh water, sea water, whatever, but the 70% of the earth is covered with the water, and 8 in 9 people have lack access to the clean water. This is a fact. Now, in 40 years, the world's population has doubled, and the water demand has been increased 4 times. 54% of the water supply used by the world population. If a tap that drips once per second will waste 1 lakh liter a year. Be careful. One drop a second will waste 1 lakh liter of water in a year. So what you have to do that? Now you know. If you are not stopping your leak faucets, you are wasting water more than you are consuming in a year. Now, 1.8 billion people will be living without water by 2025. We are in 2021. So imagine next 4 years, the situation will be drastically different. What we are not facing since last, we have not faced since last 40 years, we are going to face in next 4 years. So time is, your time starts now. You have to awake yourself and start water conservation immediately. You are in the monsoon season and you can take advantage of that. Now, 70% of our human body is consisting water. So you know the importance about your our body. I am going to take you through few fundamental medical aspects also related to your human body, and you'll know how important it is. Now, 3.4 million people die every year due to water-related disease. The data what I have, till yesterday, 4.27 million. Remember, 4.27 million people died due to corona. Up till now. And 3.4 million people per year. So if you compare the data of 2 years, last 2 years, corona, death due to corona is less than the death due to waterborne disease. Now you understand the panic situation. You need 3 liters of water per day for your body. I hope that everyone is drinking water in the correct manner. So at least 3 liters a day to keep your body up to date. Then every 20 seconds, a child dies due to waterborne illness. So out of 3.4 million, major is death is of child. We can save that. And second leading cause of death in children is diarrhea. This is because of the poor quality of water supply system and poor sanitization. Our Prime Minister Modi sir is already taken up the project of good sanitization, and we are supporting that. Now, we were discussing that 70% of earth is covered with water, but out of that only 3% of earth is having fresh water. Now, what is the fresh water? Fresh water is food for the consumption of any living animals, including human beings. So out of 70%, only 3% is fit for human consumption, right? Now, so 97% of the earth's water is salty water, which is not fit for human consumption directly. Now we know that cost of the, we are doing now that we are treating the sea water and we are using that, but the cost is different and the effluent out of that is very difficult to handle. So this is not the correct way of doing it. So 8,500 children die all over the world every day due to waterborne disease. And 270 million school days are missed due to waterborne disease every year. Now you can compare the hours wasted due to corona, death due to corona versus death due to waterborne disease and water. So contaminated water has claimed more lives than any war, accident, natural calamities. Remember that. And that is because of our habits. We are not taking adequate measures. We are not taking prevention or preventive measures of our water source. And that is the cause. It is in our hand. So 80% of all the diseases in the developing countries are related to water. So 1 liter out of 100 liters of water available on earth is for human consumption. Earlier I was talking about 3%, that is 3 liters out of 100 liters, but 1% is available. Why available? Because 2% is of water is frozen into form of ice and ice caps, and it is, we don't have direct access to that. So only 1% we have the access. So 100 liter of water is available on the earth and we have available only 1 liter. So we are left with only 1%. So now how you can prevent disease? Very simple. Adopt correct plumbing, that is for your house, and correct disposal method. This can reduce the risk of diarrhea by 35%. You don't know, the foul smell of your plumbing system will affect your body directly, because you are going to inhale the foul smell, foul air into directly through your system, through your lungs, and it is going to affect your health. So water and plumbing will go side by side. So what is, what better plumbing can do? It can provide you safe drinking water, reduces pollution of water sources, and ultimately you have very good or better quality of life. And finally, very important, very important, very important, we cannot create water. You can only transform the water from various sources. Like you can convert water from vapor, you can convert water from ice, you can convert salt water from salty water after treatment to potable or domestic water, but you cannot create water. So whatever we have, 1 liter out of 100 liter, you have that fixed volume. So if you are not going to take care of water right now, definitely next generation, they are going to suffer. So what is the solution left? Only one solution, to conserve the water. And this is, conservation is not about water. It includes, starts from the source of the water and contamination of the water sources as well. So now this is fundamental, do's and don'ts. It is about our day-to-day practice, what normally we do? We put water pots directly on the ground. Then we use hand to take out the water from the pot. I am not talking about cities only. Huh? We are also discussing about the villages, small towns where the habits are different. They are not using RO. They are not using water purifiers. And what they do? This is the starting point. And remember that our major population is from rural areas. So they are using hand to take out of the water from the pot, and they are contaminating the water. And that is the starting point. After Corona, the importance has been increased, and the water consumption also has been increased. So what is to be done? Use glass, separate glass, cup or mug, with handle or without handle, to take the water from the pot. And another thing is, keep drinking water away from the small children at certain heights, so that they cannot put their hand directly without washing into the water storage. And definitely wash the hand with soap before taking water from the pot. It is now been more focus because of the Corona. The habit of washing the hand after using toilet is more important, because it will directly affect your health. I have few videos to share with you. I am going to share the video in two lots. First, we'll see what is the situation of water, and then I'll take few more videos at the later stage, so that you can have more idea about the importance of the water. Is audible? Now, this is the situation of Chennai last year, 2019.
Water being drained out. The water that residents of Chennai, Vilivakkam area, are receiving for their daily use. Muddy, black, and unfit for human consumption.
Yeah, purely depending only on metro water, which comes only on alternatives. And even on those alternatives, it is getting mixed with sewage water.
I'm buying for 150 rupees 5 water cans every day just for the baby. Even then, now she's developed rashes all over her body. Now I'm buying another lotion which costs around 600 rupees. Root shock and a filthy stink await residents on days that they think that they are lucky enough to get clear water. This water over here is much better off than what it was yesterday. Do not get fooled by the color of the water. Let's test how it smells. When the stench is unbearable and it is completely unfit for any purpose, be it drinking, bathing, or even for washing vessels. Chennai is staring at day zero, which is fast approaching. And now the state government has pinned its hopes on the Kaveri Water Management Board, claiming that the allotted 40.43 thousand cubic meters of water has not been released by Karnataka yet. While the Kaveri board has ordered Karnataka to release water to Tamil Nadu, with clear lack of political will, Chennai could well be the first Indian city to go completely dry. With Lokpriya in Chennai, Bureau Report, India Today.
So this is another video about India situation 2020 and 2030.
Told you about cyclone value that possibly could make its way to the state of Gujarat, really sparking the beginning of the monsoon. This is the only shower they got. You can tell they're happy when umbrellas are not being used just to get a break. Then it was a week ago, the extreme heat, the pre-monsoon heat that was building, which is typical. And then yesterday talked about how the water shortage is affecting more cities than we can count. This is a rickshaw, a guy trying to get as many water jugs as he can. Notice the colors are purple, northern India, Pakistan, all the way over to Saudi Arabia. The difference is the air there is dry and it's extremely humid in northern India and all of India. So it takes a while for the body to recuperate, if it can at all. No rainfall, really much to speak of, a passing shower in Rajasthan, a little bit of cloud cover in Chennai, off the state of Kerala, where the monsoon typically begins. This is not what we need to see. The monsoon season begins on
So this is the last video before I continue with my presentation. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
So now we will discuss about 3R policy. So 3R is, first one is to reduce. Now how to reduce? The first one is to reduce the water consumption. How we can reduce the water consumption? Number one is to change the habit. I'll cover fundamentals of it. Then to stop wastage and leakages. And then again contamination of the water sources. Reuse is to collect rainwater and collect used water. Now there are several points into that we'll cover. And recycling is how to reuse the used water. So either provide certain treatment or you can sometimes use directly depending on the end use we are targeting. So how we can do it? We'll start from our own house, right? And I'll tell you that my experience is that children are the best team. Or I'll tell them army. If you teach them, they will take it forward. So target children. I have got one question, we'll take it up later on, but if you are targeting your children and change the habits of children, definitely they will insist you to change the habits. That is how the system will work. So when we are talking about train the trainers, here I'm talking about train the children. That is the fundamental. So find out water consumption in your residence. There are methods. If anyone is interested, I am ready to share how you can decide your water budget, how we are deciding our financial budget. Same way your water budget should be decided. You start measuring your water consumption at your residence, at your work premises, and monitor what should be the theoretical consumption versus practical consumption. And I believe that your practical consumption should be lesser than your theoretical consumption, and we have achieved it. I'll also going to present case study. Now you can compare the consumption, actual consumption, with acceptable norms. As per our National Building Code 2016, the water consumption for city should be between 100 to 150 liters and up to maybe 200 liters for domestic purposes and 45 liters for offices. Now, practically our target should be 70 to 80 liters of fresh water consumption. Remember, 70 to 80 liters of fresh water consumption, and we can achieve it very easily. The cost of the system will be, you will get the payback or return on the investment less than 3 years for existing premises. And if you are going to install or construct a new project, it will be less than a year. Remember, for new project less than a year, and for retrofit it will be less than 3 years. So then another is prevent wastage and leakages. One drop per second you are going to waste 1 lakh liter in a year. So we can reduce fresh water consumption by 20 to 30% by just changing your habits, stopping the leakages and stopping the wastages, right? So we are few more. I'm going to cover the habits after this. Then reuse. So now how you can reuse and what you can reuse? You can reuse rainwater. You can collect and reuse rainwater for drinking, domestic purposes. What benefits you will have? This will reduce your frozen shoulder problem, your kidney stone problem, your deficiency of B12, hair fall, discoloration. Even for who are going to cook, you will have to your cooking, your cooker whistle will time will be reduced. Instead of 3 or 4 whistles, you have to just, your work will be done in 2 whistles. Your time will be saved. Your energy, gas, everything will be saved. So if you are collecting and reusing rainwater for drinking and cooking purpose, first target, drinking and cooking. And how economically it is, the cost of one time system, and you have lifelong benefit of that. Then you can reuse the water used for utensil wash and cloth wash, for mopping, car wash, floor wash, and even the first wash of utensil. So suppose you have washing machine and your washing machine drain water, if you are collecting in a bucket, same water you can use for first washing of utensils. Remember, so this is the reuse. Now someone was asking about the reject of RO. RO reject also you can use for utensil washings, floor mopping, car washing as well. So this is the first target of reuse of your wastewater from your house, domestic purpose. Then we can, the surplus water from rain, we can always get percolate. Through percolation of using rainwater harvesting system, maybe recharge well, percolation well, whatever the system you can adopt. So ultimately you are converting it into zero liquid discharge project. Even your house can be zero liquid discharge. So reuse of rainwater and use water is the second fundamental here. And you can reduce the fresh water consumption by 10 to 100%. I'm also going to cover few fundamental calculation. So you can see how can you reduce the fresh water consumption. So last slide figure was 20 to 30% by reducing the water consumption. Second is 10 to 100% by rainwater. And third one, recycling. So recycle water, whatever the water you are using, ultimately you are going to drain it to the your sewer system, and we are not going to recycle, but yes, we should recycle it. And what are the benefits? You can use that water for flushing, gardening, washing, even for air conditioning system, water cooled plants, which is water hungry. And you know that large projects are always designed based on the water cooled air conditioning plant. And the water consumption is very high, and it's a continuous requirement. So your recycling water is fit for water cooled air conditioning system. Even you can recycle each and every drop of the water, whether it is RO reject, whether it is washing machine discharge, your utensil wash, everything can be recycled. And even the recycled water can be used for utensils and cloth washings, even for mopping, depending on the quality of recycled water you are going to get. That is depending on the type of system you are going to install and design. And I'll tell you that we have used the recycled water for the feeding of even swimming pool, water body, water park as well. So the quality of water, you can even drink that water in India now. You should have confidence on your system and your design consultant. What you are going, you are, when you are going out of India, you are drinking water from the tap, right? But when it comes to your country, you don't have confidence on the system. But yes, you can do it, and we have done it successfully. So your recycled water you can use for drinking as well. But up till now, we are just promoting and convincing people to use for flushing, gardening, washing, air conditioning system, and maybe for the makeup of water body where the human touch is not there. And by doing this, you can reduce the fresh water consumption by 20 to 50%. Now, wastage of the water. So again, I'm talking about the reducing of the consumption. So you stop pipeline leakage, wastage from the shower. If possible, try to use bucket for bathing. Use dual flushing system for WC. So you have full and half flush. Now we have reduced it from 6 liters for full flush and 3 liters for half flush. It can be further reduced to 4.5 liters for full flush and 1.5 liters for half flush. The systems are available in the market, the fittings are available in the market, and definitely it will serve your purpose. Then repair and replace your leaking taps. 1 drop per second, 1 lakh liter per year. This is the ratio to remember. Another thing, install level sensors and stopcock at your water tanks inlet so that overflow of the water. I have seen many societies, many house, they don't have the system, so their tanks are always overflowing. It's a sheer wastage of water and direct wastage. Even many people, they wash the car directly using the hose pipe and they are not using the bucket. So small thing, you can reduce the water. So this is what I was discussing. Change your habit. Even wash your vegetables and fruits in a pan, not on a running under the running tap. Then use broom to avoid washing of the hard surface. Many people, they wash the floors unnecessarily. Use drip irrigation for the garden. Recently, I have done one project with students where irrigation was done based on the moisture sensors. So when there is a need, the system will start. When there is a drop in the moisture content of the soil, best method is to irrigate the landscape below the surface. We have a habit of irrigating the plants above the surface. No. Plants need water at the root level, and most of the water we sprinkler above the soil, and most of the water above the soil is getting evaporated. So if you have done scientifically designed system, your moisture content of the soil, definitely it will help the growth of the plant, because unnecessary water is also going to damage your plant. Then dual flush we have already discussed. Auto close and sensor taps and low flow fixtures. Low flow fixtures are available in the market. Sensor taps are available in the market, and auto close systems are also available. So that is another point when you are designing a project, even your house, we can do retrofit. I'm going to cover that also. By retrofitting, you just change the aerator and your 70% of the water you are going to save. I have the case study as well. So non-running taps, just visual impact, bath, bucket and shower, the difference is there, washing and cleaning. Even your washing machine, nowadays the washing machines are available, which is not going to consume higher water against the bucket, but otherwise bucket is more economical if your washing machine selection is wrong. And too much watering in the garden, that also I have covered. This is more example of water wastage, washing the floor unnecessary, running the taps, washing the car using hose. So stop leakages. If there is a leakage on your house, who will call you? Whom will you call you? Doctor? No. Papa? No. Police? No. Plumber? Yes. Another method is, now we are adopting that, do it yourself. DIY. So small leakage you can handle yourself. We are also providing training to children so that they can stop leakages without even calling plumber. And the it's very easy and economical, because most of the taps are very easy to handle. Even many times you can do it with your hand without any tools, and tools are also very easily available. So what you should ensure, doing everything, you will have clear water, you get water every day, because then there is no higher consumption, you are more economical. Then wastewater, you will remove it very quickly, because your consumption is low and your wastewater is low. And there is no bad smell in your toilet, and you are healthy, very healthy and safe life. So this is the fundamental. You can do it your house, your premises. So now I request everyone from today, save water, no running taps, no wastage, and respect plumber. He will help you to save the water. This is I Save Water campaign, which through Indian Plumbing Association, we have promoted the concept. And this is by installing PCA. What is the meaning of PCA? Pressure Compensating Aerator. So what it will do? It will reduce unnecessary pressure on your tap. However, the filling will remain same, but water quantity, what you are getting out of the tap, will be reduced. If you have 2.5 liters per minute in place of 8 to 10 liters per minute, imagine you are going to save 70-75% of the water just by replacing. Remember, the filling will remain same. If you are washing your hand, same filling you will have, but the water consumption will be reduced. And the cost of this device is 25 to 50 rupees, not more than that. Remember, 25 to 50 rupees, but your water consumption will be reduced to by 70%. This is the device, very simple. You have to just replace the aerator. How we can do it, I'll just show you.
दीपन जी आपको ये प्रेजेंटेशन हटाना होगा. इफ यू आर रनिंग अ वीडियो यू विल हैव टू रिमूव दिस.
मैं वही कर रहा हूं.
हां 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 यस.
Are you able to see my presentation now again?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, sir, for your information, we have replaced all the aerators in Ahmedabad Airport and so many campuses. Even our Vidhan Sabha complex also we have changed, and we have got very good result. So this is the case study of SEPT University. Why am I taking case study of SEPT University? Because it's a technical education there, and we have all the measuring devices available. Now you can see that we have replaced only 63 number of aerators there, only 63. And the water we are going to save is 23 lakhs liter. This is again on conservative side, and 23 lakhs liters in a year, and percentage saved is more than 75.8% water we are going to save in a year, 23 lakhs liter, and the cost of aerator is, you can imagine, it is less than 5,000 rupees, sir. Less than 5,000 rupees, and water saved is 23 lakhs liter, and we have all the measure record for that. This is the before installation of aerator, we have measured the water. The consumption was 650 milliliter, and after installation of aerator, it is 350 milliliter. Recorded data, sir. Now, design philosophy of rainwater reuse. So we know that it's a sustainable green concept. Your capital and operating costs will be reduced, and you can achieve zero discharge if you are going to harvest, collect and reuse rainwater. Now this is the example. I have taken a case study for 4-person family. Your drinking water, drinking and cooking, I'm combining both, 5 liters a day. You need 3 liters per person for drinking and 2 liters per person for cooking, which is water used during the cooking, including vegetable washing. And for 365 days, you need 7,300 liters. And annual rainfall in Ahmedabad is average 800 millimeter. And normally we can collect 50 to 70% of total annual rainfall. Our national building code promotes 80% of the collection, but for practical purpose, we normally consider 50 to 70%. You need a storage tank of 7,500 liters, which will cost you 60,000 rupees. You need a terrace area of 15 square meter. So if you have only one hall big kitchen unit, at 50% efficiency, you can collect the rainwater for your drinking purposes for an entire year. And you need one rainy filter to collect the rainwater, and the cost of rainy filter is 10,000 rupees. Now, if I combine everything, the cost of tank is 60,000, cost of rainy filter is 10,000, I have 70,000 rupees. But for higher side, because I need pump, I need piping and controls. So the total system cost will be 1 lakh rupees for one time installation. If you spend 1 lakh rupees one time, you will have lifelong free rainwater available for your drinking purposes. And what you are going to save, you are do away with your hair fall problem, your frozen shoulder, vitamin B12 deficiency, kidney stone problem. And I'm sure if you have even problem for with any one person of the family, your medical bill will be at least 20,000 rupees in a year. 2000 rupees per month may be the cost of medicine I can consider. And this is the 1 lakh rupee cost is equivalent to one family trip within India, or maybe annual food and entertainment cost of one family for 1 year, or maybe cost of domestic appliances and gadgets for one family. So this is not the extraordinary or exorbitantly high investment, 1 lakh rupee, and definitely you have lifelong benefit. Now by doing this, we are going to save only 4% freshwater consumption. So collecting rainwater for drinking is not that percentage wise beneficial, but yes, for your human body, it is very beneficial. High TDS, high chloride, high hardness water, you are free of that. And definitely I have seen the benefits, sir. Then another example, if you want to collect entire rainwater for domestic purpose for a year, 4%, 135 liter I have considered the consumption, and 365 days, your requirement will be near to 2 lakh liter per year. And for Ahmedabad again, if you need a storage tank of 2 lakh liters, terrace area 350 square meter, which is equivalent to 4 BHK unit at 70% efficiency. And the installation cost with everything put together will be 16 lakhs rupees, which is higher. But yes, you will save 100% rainwater of your premise. And this 16 lakh rupees is equivalent to maybe two or one family trip outside India, or maybe one or two sedan car or one SUV car. If you replace your car every 3 or 5 years, definitely you can afford 16 lakh rupees to collect the entire rainwater. Sir, am I right or wrong? This is example of rainy filter. What is the function of rainy filter?
Functions of the filter: the rooftop rainwater drain pipes, downflow pipes to be joined together and connected to the inlet of rainy filter. When the rainwater flows by gravity through rainwater inlet of filter and enters the upper housing, it allows the rainwater to flow into the SS304 filter element in angular motion at specific velocity, which creates cohesive force, and this activity segregates dirt particles and clean water individually. Thereby, dirt particles and waste materials are flushed out through the drain outlet.
Installation of series of rainy filters.
When sir, we are not able to hear anything.
Audio is not there, but I think we can visualize this.
The audio is not very clear otherwise, so visually only we have to see.
Yeah. I think
mining are all comprehensive ports, segregate dust particles and clean water individually.
So basically it shows how by installation of rainy filter, the clear water and the leaves and other debris are segregated automatically, and you can collect directly without any additional treatment. Now about recycling. We have several technologies available, aerobic and anaerobic, and reed bed. Normally in green concept, we promote reed bed technology where there is no mechanical energy required. There are selection criteria, capital cost, operating cost, land and space requirement, end use quality requirement, maintenance cost, operating cost as well. And combination of anaerobic and aerobic, there are benefits. I'm not going to cover it in detail, but it's a project specific subject. So we'll discuss separately if required. It is a very detailed subject and everyone will not be interested in that. So I am going to cover one case study of Ahmedabad very premium Rajpat club, where we have done very detailed analysis on that. So figures, you know, the average annual rainfall on the site is 51,600 cubic meter. Normally 20 rainy days are there in Ahmedabad, and if we collect the rainwater from the terraces, 70% we can collect. Rainwater collection per day will be 350 cubic meter, and we have available existing storage tank was 1115 cubic meter. We have proposed additional tank of 200 meter cube. Even we have used fire water tank for the collection of rainwater, and the capacity was, if we can, if there is a consecutive rain for 3 days, we can collect the rainwater. That was the aim. I'll tell you the achievement. Total freshwater requirement was 63,145 cubic meter per year. If we recycle the water, the recycled water available was 77,745 cubic meter per year. Rainfall, we already seen the figure, 51,600 cubic meter per year. And reuse of rainwater was possible, 77,000 cubic meter per year. That was 13.5%. And target rainwater harvesting was 52% using recharge well and everything. So in total, water consumption was, earlier the water consumption was 137,785 cubic meter. Then we use recycled water, rain water, and then percolation of the excess rainwater. And saving of fresh water consumption per year was 84,745 cubic meter, which is coming around 61.5%. So that's a huge volume. And this is the annual water consumption. You see the domestic was 46%, flushing was 20%, and irrigation requirement was 34%. And we have saved around 62% of the water. So this is the water source now. Fresh water consumption, now you can see that it has been reduced to 39%. Rainwater, we are only getting 5% because of the cost of the civil work and collection system, and recycled water is 56%. And this is the budgetary cost estimate. This was the existing campus, and because of the retrofitting, the cost was high and payback period is less than 3 years. So So remember, every drop counts. You cannot create water. So only water conservation is the need of our, and we have to do it. I normally say that save the water for future generation to come. अगर अभी आपने पानी नहीं बचाया तो आपको बच्चों को पानी नहीं मिलेगा. If you love your children, save the water. That is what the concept is. And everyone should take a pledge, walk for the water. Lokendra ji, walk for the tree. Now we can do walk for the water. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Deepan ji. Thank you so much. And really, really very, I know, eye-opening and wonderful presentation, sir. I mean, and you used to show us the videos also. So these videos were also very amazing. And I am pretty much sure that, you know, you must have done lots of research and lots of homework to give this presentation. I think this is the, you know, crux. Today's presentation is crux of your, you know, entire experience of working in water field. So thank you so much, sir. It was really, really wonderful presentation. And you are very right, sir. We can generate even electricity, but we cannot generate water. It is given by God. So we must have to, preserve it. There is no other option. There is no other way. So thank you so much, sir, for the wonderful presentation. And this ASSOCHAM's Green Building Certification Program also support the water saving. And we are giving maximum points for the water conservation and water saving and water efficiency. I mean, this is the first program which is giving so much emphasis on the water saving, sir. So thank you so much. And now I would request our another wonderful speaker, Lokendra Balasariya ji. Lokendra ji is working, you know, very hard. He is running an organization, Tree Walks, and working very hard to preserve our environment. So Lokendra ji, over to you. And before this, I would request to showcase Lokendra ji's slide. Although he is not, you know, I mean, so architect Lokendra Balasariya ji is an architect and urban planner from SEPT Ahmedabad, and has his architectural and landscape design consultancy service based in Ahmedabad, with projects spread across 8 states of India. His projects have received various awards like NDTV Best Township Award, GI Head Awards for Best Commercial Complex, Best Low Rise and Best Residential Complex. His work has also been featured in different design publications. And ever since his graduation in 1990, he has been involved in academics as visiting faculty, guest lecturer, jury member, dissertation guide, etc. in various design and planning school in Gujarat. In his architectural education, he has tried to bridge the divide between professional practices and academics, having in-depth exposure to both the areas. And also a big concern has been to make students aware of our responsibility towards society and the environment as a human habitat designer. So Lokendra ji, over to you. Unmute, sir. Yeah. Unmute kijiye, sir. Ji, done, sir.
Okay, now it's
there. Yes.
Thank you, Neeraj ji, for this webinar. I would say it was a pleasure to listen to Dipen bhai talking about these very small things which can make this huge difference. You know, seriously, those calculations were wonderful, Dipen bhai, and they showed us that what a huge difference we can make, like this little aerator which you did at SEPT, you know, with this less than 5,000 rupees. And it made such a huge difference. This one drop per second, wasting 1 lakh liter per year, you know, those kind of figures, they make a lot more meaning to, you know, kind of convince ourselves. Now, Dipen bhai, there are, you know, there's so much we can discuss, but that we'll discuss someday, some other day. There are a lot of questions which people have asked. I think let's take those up. There's a very important burning question which everyone thinks about, is this RO filter. पानी भी बिगाड़ता है और मिनरल लॉस भी करता है. सो डू यू सजेस्ट सम अदर फिल्टर्स और अदर सॉल्यूशंस व्हिच कैन बिकम बेटर? समवन हैज आस्क्ड दिस, सो if you can throw some light on that, probably that can be a very interesting thing to for everyone to understand.
Yeah, Lokendraji, first I have already covered that you should collect rainwater for drinking, so you can do away with RO. Foremost solution, very important solution as well. Now, why you need to provide RO? Because your source of water, your water quality is not good, right? And definitely RO has his own side effect and disadvantages. So if you are getting water from the river or municipal corporation, no need to install RO, number one. So fundamentally, if you are collecting rainwater and reusing, no need to provide RO, only simple boiling water or any simple UV filter. So the physical and biological impurities are much lesser than your bore water or underground water. Second thing, if you are getting water from your corporation, no need to provide RO. And third, at all if you need to install RO, go with the scientific RO product. Maybe it will be costlier, but you need a minimum 180 to 200 TDS for your body. And mostly the domestic RO, they work on the 90% rejection. I'll give you the example. Suppose your input TDS is 1000, 90% rejection means your RO water will have only 100 TDS. So most of the domestic RO are unfit for the installation, I'll tell you that. And ultimately your RO water is also unfit for your human consumption. And you have all the problems like B12 deficiency or frozen shoulder and so many things. So if you at all you need to install RO, please use the right product. If you don't know, please consult appropriate person and select the model act. And every 3 months you should test, like your thermometer, TDS meter is available in the market at the same price. Buy a TDS meter and measure the TDS regularly, so that if your TDS is less than 180 or 200, you can adjust. Scientifically designed RO, you can adjust the TDS, you can do the blending, and always you have desired TDS level and other minerals. Even additional cartridge is available, so that your minerals, you can maintain the desired mineral of after the RO.
This is very nice, you know, this 180 to 200 TDS. I think everyone should note this down as a prerequisite for their drinking water quality from the RO, and insist that the RO maintenance team or the manufacturer team gives us that quality of water. Probably we'll waste less and we'll be having little more healthier water. It's a very interesting question, Dipen, which someone has asked, is saying, will interconnecting rivers really help somewhere our country in the water crisis? Is a huge question, but it's a very interesting different question. If you can say something.
No, definitely I'll tell you, I'll give you one classic example. अगर आप लोगों ने स्कूल में पढ़ा होगा कि हाईएस्ट रेनफॉल इन इंडिया इज एट चेरापुंजी, राइट? जस्ट गो थ्रू द डेटा ऑफ चेरापुंजी, आईएमडी, इंडियन मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट वेबसाइट. नाउ चेरापुंजी देर इज नो रेन वाटर, देर इज नो रेन इन फैक्ट. सो वी नो दैट द शिफ्टिंग ऑफ सीजन्स सीन इन द वीडियो, इवन द डिले इन द मॉनसून. Now earlier the Rajasthan there and Kutch, there was no rain, rainfall, proper rainfall. Now there are floods, their lakes are overflowing. So we know that there is a change in the system, ecologic entire system is I can tell you that nature is adjusting. Whatever damage we have done to the nature, nature has the habit to adjust itself, and it is doing that. So the problem we have created, nature has the solution with own system. So I don't know, but connecting river, the benefit will be, I don't know the cost, but where there is excess water, the excess water we can divert to the scarred areas. What we are doing in Sardar Sarovar, we are collecting water from the Madhya Pradesh and we are diverting it to the water-scarce areas, right? So similarly, interconnecting of river, definitely it will help, but we have to understand the ecology of the system, because river and surrounding areas, their own ecology system, and we cannot disturb, because everything around the river is dependent on the water flowing in the river. Now again, when you are stopping the flowing water, the side effects are horrible. Living river and dead river, there is a difference, right? So you have to design the system so that the flowing river remains flowing and the surplus water only is transferred to the water scarce areas. And it's a huge subject, and I am not expert on the ecology. So, but yes, it will definitely help.
What you are saying is very true, that the cost and ecological implications of connecting rivers can be huge, so they might be useful, but there would definitely be simpler solutions which can be implemented to make this, you know, more easy, the water problem. Now, very interesting, Dipen bhai, you know, I like the understanding in the philosophy with which you work, that when agar chakku se kat jata hai to talwar lane ki kya zarurat hai, kind of thing. So thank you. So
there is one additional point. Now many times we construct check dams. Now what is the benefit of check dams? It stops the water, but it doesn't even stop water permanently. Excess water always get overflow and it keeps on flowing downstream, right? So you have check dams at the certain level where there is a need. If you go to the northern part of the country, they always divert river through the village, and ultimately same river again it will merge with the downstream. So that is the concept we should look at it. So northern part of the country, they understand, because they were so excess water during the rainy season, but after the rainy season there is no water, because the geography structure is like that. So there is no other solution, and they can't store water permanently. Is the cost, we know the cost. So
there are very interesting examples we have. Actually, I'll just finish this small thing. In Kutch, we have a friend who's taken up 7 or 12 villages, and they worked on just rain water. And all the male members of the village had left because there was no water, so there was no agriculture. After 6 years of rainwater management, anywhere they dig, they get water in the well. So the agriculture has come back. The young people of the villages have come back to the village, and the village is much more prosperous. And they are not using Narmada water; they are just managing the rainwater in a little nice way. So very interesting. Tatuji, you wanted to ask a question, please.
Yeah. First of all, I want to compliment Dipen bhai for a wonderful presentation, and then ask him a very important question. That I was told, I am not too sure, I have not really verified this, but the wastage in agriculture, the water wastage in agriculture is huge as compared to domestic water wastage. And if you waste, say, 100 liters of water in the domestic scenario, there would be, you know, millions of liters of water wasted in the agricultural sector, because number one, there is no guidance system in place for the farmers, and whatever water that they get, they generally simply make it flow into the farms. So that is one. Should we do something about that? Another thing is, should we also revisit the standard of 135 liters per capita per day, which is, I think, an age-old standard. Now looking at the increasing demand every year, should we not reduce that standard so that with the kind of methods which you have shown, why don't the National Building Code reset that standard to say 100 liters, for example? Because some places in the country don't even get 60 liters per capita per day. So if they can live, anybody can live within, say, 100, if you can reduce it by, say, 30% or so, which amount of water will be saved that way? So these are the two questions. And another piece of information, you were mentioning about Cherrapunji. Now it has been replaced by Mahabaleshwar in Maharashtra as the highest rain receiving region.
Tata sir, I think I have already covered both the topics. Number one, we always give example of Israel. So when it comes to agriculture, I was talking about the irrigation, moisture sensor based irrigation system and root zone irrigation system. So basically, yes, the cost I don't know because I'm not into that field. But definitely, if we cover that, I'll tell you that your agriculture requirement will be reduced to 20%. If you have moisture-based irrigation system, whenever there is a need, different crop will have different requirement. So based on the requirement, your sugar cane will have different requirement. Your maybe rice will have different water requirement. So based on the requirement, if you install the system, definitely your water consumption is going to reduce. And even when you are changing the crop, you there is a this, you can always change the system, not the system, but the settings. So suppose your moisture content requirement for one crop is a certain mm of water, and another crop will have double the requirement. You can always change the setting and you can have more water for the irrigation. So what the system will do, even if required, I'll share you the details. The as soon as your soil dries out, it will, the sensor will sense the moisture content of the soil and it will give the command to the supply system, and your supply system will be switched on. And as soon as the desired level of moisture content is achieved, the system will stop supplying the water. So there is no overwatering and there is no underwatering of the system, right? So this is this can be done and this can be achieved. And your dependency on rainwater and other source of the water will reduce because ultimately your consumption is reduced.
Yes.
Even your golf course, one full golf course, the water requirement is around 15 to 16 lakh liter alternate day. And if you adopt that system, so yes. And that is a, what was the another question? I forgot.
It was regarding resetting the per capita per day.
Yeah, that also I have covered that instead of 135 liter, it should be 70 to 80 liters. Now, the people who are from Bombay, they know that the Mumbai Municipal Corporation, they only supply 50 liters per capita per day. And rest of the water you have to manage because they have fixed source, fixed water sources. They cannot collect more water, right? So the population is increasing, so water supply is decreasing. It's an inverse situation. So if you adopt all three R policies, your water consumption, you can reduce at least 70 liter per capita per day. And I'll give you one example. It is not based on the per capita, but one project we did, the inlet water quality was 4,000 TDS. I'll tell you that beyond 2,000 TDS, our code says that IS 10500, that it is not fit for human consumption. Now inlet was 4,000 TDS. Our entire water holding capacity of the project was, rather circulation of the water, everything was 17 lakhs liter per day. And the system design that you only need 40,000 liters of fresh water. Remember, 17 lakhs of liter is the requirement and we are doing recycling. And only 40,000 liters you need fresh water. 4,000 TDS, sir. So system is available. And we are not using the technology and we are not doing the right type of engineering, I can say you that. Otherwise, you can achieve it. And 70 to 80 liters is not that it's a rocket science, I'll tell you that.
I think some people has written in the chat, they want to connect to you after this talk. So if you can put your contact details in the chat, it will be nice that someone will be, those who want to reach out to you and connect for further discussion, it'll be a very helpful thing, because people like you need to spread your knowledge to more people, and probably, you know, the society will benefit. Neeraj ji, it's 6:40, so do you think we should take more questions, or we should now end the session here?
I think there are many questions, and what is the subject, you know, we can have any number of questions, but considering this Saturday evening and weekend evening, I think we should close the webinar. But before you know, handing over to you for extending the vote of thanks.
Neeraj ji, I want to add here that we would like more of his sessions in other chapters also, and taking the vision forward. I think it was very interesting, Dipenbhai, and I want your more time from Asutan Jim be taken to various others. I'm sure a lot of people have not taken advantage of this. Neeraj ji note that
bilkul considering
what,
that
what Anand ji what he said, and in terms of bringing down the water quantity, and if we should through our GEM program can always inspire people by setting new standard, giving additional credit some engineer or some client is, or some building is getting designed with less water consumption. We of course give credits, but there could be super credits given if there are super efforts made on the water side. I think that is something which we need to look at our credit system. So I will request Lokendra ji and Dipenjay to help me on this, how we can make our credit side of water conservation more stronger.
Sure, I think we can offer some bonus points for extraordinary effort.
Yes, sir.
Correct. I cannot change NBC, but we can together can do some improvement in GEM program, definitely. Yes. Which creates indirectly awareness, and someday some more senior people will understand the importance of it in much better way, and probably change their our codes also. And of course, people like Dipenbhai are the people who are going to write tomorrow's code in the country. So I have no doubt we will take this vision forward.
It is so important that it is said that the third world war will be fought over water. So
correct. We should.
Sir, I'll tell you that, sir, already started. You know, the Karnataka and that border. It is there. It's China, not that world level, but it's already state level. We are facing that.
China has some evil designs, you know, to stop water of certain countries, to put them in difficult spot. So the World War III will be fought over water. That is what people say. Anyway, I think it was a very nice session. And as Neeraj ji said, it is quite late for the Saturday evening. So maybe we can have one more session like this in the time to come.
Ji.
Neeraj ji, I already said my contact details. If anyone wants to ask the question, they can ask. So
definitely, sir. So I'll share your email ID with the team, with the attendees, so that they can send the questions to you. So before handing over to Lokendra ji for extending the vote of thanks and the way forward, I would like to, you know, thank our attendees, you know, because, you know, considering this Saturday evening, and in fact late Saturday evening, there were approximately 200 attendees were listening this program. So it was really amazing and really wonderful. Aur bilkul sir, I think water ka jo problem hai, ye problem definitely bahut bada hai, lekin iske I think jo measures hain, jo efforts hain, I think wo bahut chote chote efforts hain jo hum log apne ghar se apni family ke sath shuru kar sakte hain. I mean, it is not something like ki hame kuch bahut zyada investment karna hai. I think jaisa Deepan ji has said, there are very small, you know, good deeds, green good deeds, I must say, jisko hum apni family level pe implement karke bhi, we can save huge, huge amount of water. So thank you so much, Deepan ji. And now I would request Lokendra ji for, you know, extending the official vote of thanks and the way forward. Lokendra ji.
Thank you, Neeraj ji. Deepan ji, a big thanks to you, first of all, for this wonderful presentation. I'm sure you would have done a lot of work to get all this data together, to put them in sequence and build up a logic which is very acceptable and very understandable for people. A big thanks to you. I know this is just a beginning. And thanks to Anand ji and the whole SOCHM team, Pangaj ji, Neeraj ji, Amit ji, everyone who put this wonderful program together. You know, it's very important to have more discussions like this. And like Neeraj ji was saying, I would thank all the participants for being here, which shows that, you know, probably water as a concern is definitely something which we all accept, we all understand, and we all want to participate to do something. Let's have more meetings like this. Thank you, Dipen ji, once again. Thanks, everyone. Goodbye and good evening.
Thank you, Loken ji. And I would like to take this liberty from SOCHM GEM Gujarat team, Anand Tatu ji, Loken ji, Dharkar saab, and Deepan ji, that we have a wonderful speaker with us, Lokendra Balasariya ji, you know, who is the expert on rainwater harvesting system. So I would request Lokendra ji to plan a webinar on rainwater harvesting system. And we would love to host this webinar on SOCHM GEM Gujarat platform. So thank you so much, Lokendra ji. Thank you, Anand Tatu ji, Deepan ji. Ji, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Amit, please close the webinar. Thank you.